What's up, y'all? It's the Marginite. It's time for another one. So, we got a lot to unpack today. And this is all centered around the Birds of Prey movie. Or should I say now, it is the Harley Quinn Birds of Prey movie. So, I want to go through a couple things before I get into the actual meat and potatoes of this. But I didn't pull this up because you could just go on Twitter and just... Because it's so much stuff to try to cipher through to get, you know, get through the nonsense. But I will say this. You know, right now, the Birds of Prey is underperforming. Some people call it a flop. I'm just going to say it's underperforming at this point. Just for the simple fact that it's only been, not even a full week yet. So, it came out Friday. Yeah, so it came out Friday. So, yeah. So, I want to say it's underperforming. So, we got a lot of back and forth going on is, why is this movie not, you know, performing well? Of course, you have the constant narrative that's always put out there. The istophobia, blah, 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 men don't support women movies, all that stuff, which is cold trash. And somebody put that up on their Twitter, and I actually said something to them. And I just named a few, probably like 10 or so leading female stories where nobody had a problem with. So I get really tired of hearing that. So we know that was going to happen. But then the thing that comes up is about the rated R thing. That wasn't a problem with Deadpool or Joker. I'm just saying. So when I hear that rated R, excuse thrown out there, it's stupid. And I'm going to piggyback off of Young Ripper a little bit too, because he put up a very, very good, and I want to put that in the description. Go check out his history of Birds of Prey / review. It's about an hour long, so if you're taking a ride down a car ride to work or whatever, or you're just doing some work around the house, definitely give it a listen. He definitely opened, I mean, I knew who the Birds of Prey were, but he went into in depth of all of the, you know, even if they were parts, you know, quick members, whatever, or people who interacted with them. One of the things that stands out is that Harley Quinn had nothing to do with the Birds of Prey, other than maybe a quick, you know, passing through. So I've always said this because, you know, with my limited comic book knowledge that I know about the Gotham City Sirens. This should have been Harley Quinn and the Gotham City Sirens. I think that would have went over better with a lot of people, especially since Harley Quinn is a villain, even though I know they're trying to give almost that anti-hero feel to her. I guess you could say that, but she's still a villain, or anti-hero, you should say, at least now that she's really separated from the Joker. But I think Gotham City Sirens would have been a better choice for this movie. You could have had Harley Quinn, which would have made more sense. Poison Ivy and Catwoman. Boom. And this way you have characters that people are fully aware of, you know. And it's not like, I mean, obviously, you know who Black Canary is. And obviously, you know, especially like somebody like myself, I watched the Arrowverse, even though technically, I guess he technically couldn't call it the Arrowverse anymore since Arrow is gone. But I guess, yeah, Arrowverse. So, I've known about the Hunters. I've known about the Hunters before anyway, just because I played DC Universe Online and all that stuff. You know, there's versions of the Hunters where she's Batman and Catwoman's daughter. So I knew about that version. Of course, I also knew about the Bertinelli version of her also. So the Birds of Prey, and even with the Hunters, she was not a founding member. So, you know, and this is why I said I'm going to piggyback a little for Young Ripper. I didn't know, was that Oracle / Batgirl, a.k.a. Barbara Gordon, who was, you know, put into a wheelchair by the Joker, was the Oracle and was a founding member of the Gotham, Birds of Prey, along with Black Canary. Now, I've already said my problems with the Black Canary being changed. They should have put Vixen in there if they wanted to do what they were doing, you know, by having that particular character the way she was. Should have been Vixen. I don't understand why in their head they had to change that, because that was unnecessary when you had Vixen, who's literally was a part of the Birds of Prey, even if it was for a short time, but still she was part of the Birds of Prey. It would have made more sense to do that and then have Black Canary as, you know, Black Canary, you know. But here's the thing that gets me. And this is where we're going to start again. I want to go into a couple of articles real quick. Actually, really, one article and one headline. But before we get into that, the thing that bounces around, which was what I was saying, it was such a rabbit hole in Twitter trying to, you know, pinpoint where, because it's like that narrative has been thrown around so much, the outfits. All right, so you get the one side of it, oh, men don't like it because they're not, you know, they're not wank material, you know, whatever. Okay, so in the comics, yes, you're going to have a very idealized version of men and women in comics. So when they say Harley doesn't look like her comic book counterpart, it's not necessarily about her being over-sexualized of sorts. It's about her not looking like her character. Now, you can say, well, she really looked like her character in Suicide Squad. But, okay, but she still... It looked good. Like, the outfits look good on her. The outfits, I mean, I really didn't care because I'm like, I was just trying to get, you know, I didn't mind this movie, so let's be perfectly clear. I didn't have a problem with the movie. I think it was, it tried to be Deadpool a little too much. I think that's one of the problems. And of course, the changes and the fact that Harley Quinn had nothing to do with the Birds of Prey, I knew that. Now, what I didn't know, what I did look up myself, was that Cassandra Cain is actually supposed to be an assassin. They nerfed her completely when you look at the backstory that she is supposed to have. Cassandra Cain is not supposed to be just some random kid. It's supposed to be basically, you know, trained to be a bodyguard for Ra's al Ghul, if I'm correct. Like I said, check out Young Ripper to get a full breakdown of that. By them doing what they did, it turned off a lot of people. Which leads us to this. Now, I'm going to pull this up real quick. And we're going to take a look at this real fast. So, this is from Screen Rant. And the crazy thing about it is, you know, they say, you know, it's flopping and all that stuff. Yeah. I'm going to reserve my judgment for a flop. It still has some time. Hopefully, they don't... I mean, they're going to have some cop coming up on Friday with Sonic, but we'll see what happens. Birds of Prey for this, I'm sorry, this is from a Screen Rant, like I was saying. Birds of Prey's opening weekend audience was shockingly 54% male. So instead of it being 50-50, it was 54, and then what I guess 54-46, right? Yeah, 54-46, if it was to split that, right? So it says, despite being a female-driven film, the opening weekend audience for Birds of Prey was instead fueled by men, with males making a 54% of the crowd. So this will you have that little bit of chicken-egg scenario, a little conundrum, if you will, where you get people saying, oh, it's just men, you know, reviewing it. But it's mostly men going to see it. And... once again, when you talk about the demographic, yes, you always had, you don't get to where you are if only one person is buying. Henceforth, this statistic right now. So when you have mostly only one demographic buying, of course, you're going to have a lower turnout. So with comics, it was never really, comics really, while comics was a big, you know, a decent industry, of course, not now. You know, you could, you know, look at what's going on as far as, you know, things in the mainstream comic industry. But even with that being said, it was mostly guys. So it was really like a niche thing. So when you see the numbers like this, it's reflecting almost that same niche type of feel. Because remember, you don't get that big Avengers style type of thing if it's just a niche market getting it. You can't get that. It's not going to happen. So when you see 54% male, that almost mirrors what an actual, you know, comic book store would be. You have mostly males going in. That's your demographic. So you got that situation. So let's look at this article a little bit in a little more detail. Birds of Prey scored mostly positive reviews and was notched and has a notched a Rotten Tomatoes score at 80% as of writing down from the start from the weekend, which was certified fresh. Despite, however, Birds of Prey found itself struggling to meet expectations at the box office. The film is initially expected somewhere around $50 million, but in the end, Birds of Prey only earned $33.2 million. This is marked one of the lowest openings for a DC film and the worst of the entire DCEU. Yikes. So, again, when you hear people talking about the outfits and stuff like that, it's because they didn't look anything like they were. So that automatically is going to turn people off, right? They're not looking like that because when you look at the pictures of them, they look like just normal people in normal clothes, which I get. If you want to base it off of reality, you can say that, but it was still. It was like a weird spot where you're trying to say you're trying to base it like reality, by keeping people like not having it. But even still, with that, at the end of the movie, they had like costumes on. You know what I'm saying? Which, okay, I know it might be difficult for people to put to go exactly with the costume. But then again, Shazam had his regular costume. Even Aquaman, even when he got hit, when he got the trident. He had his regular costume. Superman always has his regular costume. Batman always tweaks his, but it's still his costume. You can put people in something very close to their comic book version costume and not have a problem. But by them not doing that, I think that turned people off. And it wasn't because it's not wank material. I understand when people trying to play people out. And again, at the same time. I understand where you get from when people say that, oh, they're not looking like that. Do you try to flip it on them? It's not that it's about wanker material. I hate when people say that because that's not the case. It's because they don't look like they do in the comics. Make them look something like they do in the comics. And on top of that, it's when we really break it down to nuts and bolts, it's actually condescending and insulting to all parties around because you're going to sit there and say, Margot Robbie looks good in anything. You want to say just because she's dressed a certain way, she doesn't look good? That's just stupid. I mean, Kate Winslet, she looked good. What's that? Yeah, Kate Winslet. And Journey Smollett, right? I guess that's what, yeah, Journey Smollett. I'm terrible with the name, sorry. And of course, you had my girl in there from Do the Right Thing. I just went blank on her name, but you know what I'm talking about. Matoya. she was in there. And of course, she still looks great for her age, you know what I'm saying? I'm not knocking her. She, I see beauty and all that stuff. But by them not looking like how they look, I think that was a turn off to people. And when they're talking about the outfits. And of course, the marketing. The marketing is what hurt this thing. So let's continue with this real quick because I don't want to go too long with this video. So now that the dust has settled, following disappointing news. More stats emerging about Birds of Prey weekend performance. Many expected women to come out in droves to see a female-fronted film, but according to Variety, the majority of ticket buyers were male. Post-track surveys calculated the audience was 54% male and 65% over the age of 25. While the gender split is close to 50-50, it still indicates that women weren't as interested in Harley's latest adventure, which again. When you look at this stat, it to me it mirrors what you actually have seen in the actual comic book store. And I, obviously been a while since I went to comics, but again, your demographic is mostly male. You're gonna have females there. Again, this is the thing. People keep acting like, oh, females were. It's like, oh, this was an all boys club. No girls were allowed before. No, silly. It's just it wasn't all girls were. No girls were allowed. It was the fact that. Girls weren't interested in that. Hey, when I grew up, me having a comic book was not the cool thing to do. Girls didn't think that was cool. They kind of poked fun at you when you had the comic book in your hand. It wasn't a cool thing for girls to do. And that's the thing people, it's like over your head. Like, girls weren't into it. It's just thing. Sure, you might have a more a bigger surge of it now, but I think it's again, the hardcore comic book fans that are girls were going to be there. That was probably your percentage of women who went. But again, your majority was going to be men. That's just what I'm saying with that. Now, with all that being said, right? With all that being said, and I didn't pull up an article for this, but everybody's been talking about it. But this is the headline I said I was going to bring up. And this is from CNN. It says, Warner Brothers tweaks the name of its box office flop. I hate that they use flop. Just say box office mediocre, I guess. Birds of Prey. So Birds of Prey tonight brought a disappointing box office this weekend, despite the views and poor show, mostly because of its adults only. And of course, that's dumb. Now they switched it from Birds of Prey and Fantabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn, which is stupid and long. I don't know why they did that, to Harley Quinn and Harley Quinn Birds of Prey, which again, I think the whole premise of that was just dumb. It should have been Harley Quinn Gotham City Sirens. I just think that's what they should have did. And they could have had the Birds of Prey in this movie and had them fighting the Birds of Prey. And I think that actually made more sense. Because once again, I say, now again, to me, when I watched this movie, it didn't seem like he was getting hit over the head with the whole agenda-based entertainment. But when you take a step back and look at it, which I really wasn't paying attention when I went there, but you know, just over listening to what people said, and you take a step back and look, all of the villains, well, the antagonists in there, douchebags in the movie, were guys. Which was, okay, I can see where you can say there was an issue with that. People get tired of that nonsense. What should have happened, you should have had Gotham City Sirens versus the Birds of Prey. And you could have even done something like, you know, do a quick introduction of how Barbara Gordon becomes Oracle, how, you know, she meets up with Black Canary, and then, of course, you could have had Huntress. You could have had Huntress in there. I say leave Huntress in there. And then you could have just had Poison Ivy, you know, Catwoman, and Harley Quinn. You know, you could have did something like that and have them be the, you know, the rival teams in there. You know what I'm saying? I think that would have made a much more compelling movie, and you could have did what you did, whatever. But anyway, I think I've chatted you up long enough. So, at the end of the day, I think they dropped the ball. I think they realized they dropped the ball, and they're trying to fix it now. So, how do y'all feel about that? Are you like, well, they should have started with Sirens, or are you cool with them changing it to Harley Quinn and the Birds of Prey, or whatever? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, and subscribe, and of course, hit that notification button so you get my face on the job. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace.